Beginning on January 1st, 2017, the Food and Drug Administration has new rules that will apply to the use of certain antimicrobials in animal feed. Antimicrobials that are important for human medicine, also known as medically important antimicrobials, will be available for use in feed only when authorized by a licensed veterinarian under the Veterinary Feed Directive Rule, or VFD rule. Medically important antimicrobials will no longer be available over the counter for use in feed. The VFD rule permits FDA to approve animal drugs that can be used in or on feed only when ordered by a licensed veterinarian. Animal drugs in this category are called VFD drugs. When VFD drugs are in or on feed, the feed is known as VFD feed. Another change as of January 1st, 2017, is that the labels of medically important antimicrobials for use in animal feed will no longer include the statement that these drugs can be used to promote growth or increase feed efficiency. The animal drug industry, in cooperation with FDA, is voluntarily removing those claims from the labels. Why the changes? To address the issue of antimicrobial resistance. Bacteria develop resistance to the antimicrobial drugs used to fight them. That's what's meant by the term antimicrobial resistance. It's not just an issue in human medicine. It's an issue in veterinary medicine, too. Antimicrobial resistance poses a threat to both human and animal health. And FDA has a responsibility to address the risks to humans and to animals. So here's how the VFD regulation works. Under this regulation, FDA requires your veterinarian to be engaged in a veterinarian client-patient relationship, or VCPR, with you and with the animals to be treated. The VCPR is a set of requirements for the working relationship the veterinarian has with the client, who is the animal's owner or caretaker. And it requires the veterinarian to have sufficient knowledge of the animals to order or authorize the treatment, control, or prevention of disease in those animals. The veterinarian will make a diagnosis of the disease status of the specific group of animals and, if it's appropriate, issue a veterinary feed directive, or VFD, that authorizes use of an approved VFD drug or an approved combination VFD drug in feed for your animals. The VFD rule requires several pieces of information on the VFD, including identification of the veterinarian, of you, the veterinarian's client, the animals to be treated, the VFD drug to be used, and directions for use of the VFD feed, which includes the level of the drug in the VFD feed and the length of treatment. The VFD will also give the expiration date, which is the last date the VFD feed covered by the order can be fed. If further treatment is required, ask your veterinarian to assess the health of your animals and the need for another VFD. The VFD will include a statement saying that use of the VFD feed in a manner other than as directed on the labeling is not permitted. Using the feed in ways not on the label is using the feed in an extra label fashion. Examples of extra label use for VFD feeds include feeding animals for a period longer than specified on the order, or feeding a VFD feed with a VFD drug at a level different than what's specified on the label. The veterinarian may issue a VFD order on paper or electronically. If it's on paper, the veterinarian will give you a copy along with a second copy for you to give to the VFD feed distributor. Or the veterinarian will give you a copy and send another copy directly to the VFD feed distributor. If the veterinarian issues and signs the VFD electronically, you and your distributor will receive a copy electronically. You must keep a copy of the VFD order for at least 2 years from the date it was issued. You can obtain the feed once the distributor has received a copy of the VFD order, In fact, the distributor cannot release a VFD feed to you unless it has received a copy of the signed VFD order from your veterinarian. Some animal producers can obtain a VFD drug in the form of a type A medicated article, which is used to manufacture a type C medicated feed. A VFD is not required for you to obtain the type A medicated article, but you will be required to have a VFD order from your veterinarian prior to feeding the VFD feed made with the type A article to your animals. Feeding VFD feed without an order from a veterinarian is unlawful. In addition, you would be required to manufacture the VFD feed in compliance with the VFD drug approval as well as the medicated feed current good manufacturing practice requirements. If the VFD drug type A medicated article is category 2, then a VFD feed from such a drug can be manufactured only at a licensed feed mill. Licensed feed mills are required to manufacture medicated feed in compliance with the current good manufacturing practice requirements for licensed feed mills. If you'd like to see more information and other videos about VFD feeds, please come to CVM's Safe Feed webpage at www.fda.gov/safefeed. Thank you.